Alright, you guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm glad you're here. So, today we're not going to talk about multi-level marketing companies. We're going to talk about something even better. River cruising. Why? Because it's a passion of mine. Travel is a huge passion of mine. And so, I took a poll and I asked you guys, what do you guys want to know about? And a lot of you have said, I want to know more about river cruising, and I want to live vicariously through you. Now, as you guys know, my very first cruise was the Viking Grand European Tour. This was in November of 2015, and David and I went over, and we went on the Mimmer was the ship we were supposed to be on, but we never actually saw that ship because the river levels were low. We were on three different Viking ships, but I can tell you this, all of them are exactly the same. So today, this is the map. This is what you get to do. But today, the first thing I'm going to talk about is the food. Why? Because Viking River Cruise has some of the best food on the planet. So I'm going to just pull up a slideshow and we're going to go over things. So in Amsterdam, we went to Sakassa. It's in the, it's in the Renaissance Hotel by Marriott, okay? And we had the dinner special because this was the day we arrived in Amsterdam. So there's the focaccia bread with the olive oil. There's our champagne. That was the ricotta thing. That was the tomato basil soup. That was the linguine with bolognese. That's the tiramisu. So now let's go to the breakfast buffet the following morning. Abelskivers, a very cool Dutch pancake. They're the little pancakes. Sometimes they're puffy, sometimes they're not. We have the hard-boiled egg, the fresh fruit, the croissants. I live for croissants when I am river cruising. And then we have Calvé, which is basically Nutella, but that's what it's called in Amsterdam. Really good stuff. Okay, and this is the other thing I like about Amsterdam and Europe. Their yogurt comes in little glass jars and they recycle them. Why can't we do that in the US? Why can't we put things in glass jars and then return the jars for the deposits? Why don't we do that in the US? I don't get it. Anyway, keeping going. So David and I did in Amsterdam a walking food tour. Now, this guy right here is Sean. He's from Wisconsin, and he was an excellent tour guide. And he took us to Vlemix. It is the oldest French fry stand in Amsterdam. And it's awesome, okay? This particular stand has been around since 1957, but it originated in 1887. And they have a whole bunch of different sauces, but how do they eat French fries in Amsterdam? With mayonnaise. I got the garlic creamy sauce. David had the mayonnaise. Those are the French fries. They were delicious. And then we went over to Harem's and we got a sausage at the Harem's. Okay. Or Hema. And it was really good. And that's how hot dogs are cooked there. And then we explored the grocer, and I love how everything at the grocer is freshly prepared. These are all smoothies that you can buy, freshly prepared smoothies, always really good. And then doesn't that hazelnut tort look amazing? It was. So, and then they have a whole sandwich bar, and then the coffee bar. More juices, more sandwiches. And then this is what I was talking about. This is the pickled herring with onions and pickles. This was not my thing. This was David's thing. It was, I'm just going to say, I tried it. You don't have to like it, but you have to try it. That's something David has always said to me. You don't have to like it, but you have to try it. I did like that waffle, though. And then this is another juice bar, and it's really close to Dam Square in Amsterdam. And the juices are really good. And then this is Bowls. This is also on an episode of Travel Man. So if you've ever seen Travel Man with Richard Ayoade, they go to this very same place, Bowls, and they have juniper gin. And you headbutt the gin and you drink it real fast. It is very strong alcohol, you guys. And then there's Dill and Camille. And then this is another favorite restaurant that we like to go to in Amsterdam. It's called Der Rosenboom. It's basically Rose Blossom. And I love the decor in here with all the blue and white. And we had this schnitzel with poutine. And there's the mushroom gravy for your poutine. Okay. And then apple strudel with ice cream. And then the next day, we get up and we head to the Viking ship. So they had a little reception where you could have a little, like, tea time. So this is something that they served at tea time. That is a little bacon club sandwich with a pasta salad and a few fruit skewer. Kind of fuzzy. That's a bad picture. And that's Vanya. She was the maitre d'. And this is the dining room on the Viking cruise ship for the river cruises. Now, the dining room is very small and intimate, but so are Viking river cruises, you guys. The cruise ships are 150 passengers max. So on the first night, and that's a bad picture too, the first night in Amsterdam, when you get on the ship, and it doesn't matter which cruise you go on, if your cruise is in Amsterdam, this is the menu, okay? Baked Amsterdam cheese souffle. It's honestly my favorite. They have a marinated radish on top with a sour cream drizzle on top. It's really, really good. They also have a crab meat or tuna tartare. And then they have the arugula cherry tomato pine nut salad, which I also get. And the split pea and ham soup with crispy bacon and creme fraiche. Honestly, my first night on the ship, I just had three souffles, the salad, and the soup, and it was delicious. But this is something that they had for the main course. You could have roasted duck breast with a braised duck leg, honey barbecued filet of salmon, sauteed vegetables in a crisp tortilla. And then for dessert, they have a chocolate pot de creme, which is basically a chocolate mousse. And they put a pineapple mint salsa on top. The ice cream they made that day was vanilla. The sorbet they made that day was cherry. And then you could have chocolate, butterscotch, or berry on your ice cream. They always have available cheesecake. And they always have available the fruit plate for those who want to, you know, watch their weight while they're on a cruise. But honestly, you're on a cruise, you're there to eat, okay? And then, of course, they have the cheese plate that comes with a mango thyme chutney, and the cheese plate of the day for Amsterdam is Gouda, or Gouda, okay? And Gorgonzola cheeses. So you get Gouda and Gorgonzola, both really good. And then this is the standard menu that's available every single night on the Viking cruise ships. You can get a Caesar salad with anchovies, a sauteed salmon filet, a chicken breast, or the ribeye steak. Once, you have to have the ribeye steak at least once. And every meal comes with a wine pairing, or you can have soda pop, or you can have water or coffee, or you can have all of it. It's up to you. There's the cheese souffle, you guys. It was so good. There's the split pea and ham soup, and there's the arugula salad. That is the duck breast with the duck leg. I believe David had that. There's a better picture of it. There's the duck breast with the little croquettes, our little potato croquettes. Okay. And then there is the pain au chocolat stuff. There's the cheese plate behind it, and there's the pineapple mango chutney. Yeah, it was good. All right. Here is the breakfast buffet the following morning. As you can see, my phone is right there. So you can have your own omelet made to order. Again, croissant, potatoes, sausage, mushrooms, bacon, fresh fruit, yogurt, coffee, cranberry juice, fresh fruit on the table. And there's a coffee bar in the ship that is available 24 hours a day. So if you can't sleep, you can get up, go get yourself a coffee, a latte or an espresso, and then sit in the living room of the ship and read a book. It's really nice. There is the salmon and more potatoes, scrambled eggs, sauteed onions and stuff. That's what David had. And then on to lunch. A shrimp salad, I believe. There's the salad bar. Very good. Here's a lunch menu. Shrimp cocktail and avocado. So that's what I had, the shrimp cocktail. Or you could have the smoked duck breast and orange salad. So if they didn't have all the stuff used up from the night before, it's used the next day in lunch. The cheese and beer soup is another thing that is absolutely amazing. Okay, just gonna say it. The penne, they have a spinach, prosciutto, and garlic penne pasta. Or you could get the hutspot Dutch beef stew, which is basically a beef stew with peas, carrots, and celery. Or the BLT sandwich. Okay. And then the desserts for lunch are the Flying Dutchman, which is a stroop waffle with ice cream. Or the rice pudding. That's the Flying Dutchman. So that's a really bad picture, so I'll read it to you. So day two on the ship. Your welcome dinner, you have smoked salmon carpaccio or potato-crusted mascarpone cheese, a tossed mussels salad with fresh egg, or a roasted tomato soup with basil. I had the tomato soup. And then they have the main course is a charcuterie brand, which is buttered vegetables, potatoes, and I don't know what the meat was, or the caramelized sea scallops, do those. And the zucchini baked with goat cheese and sun-dried tomatoes. That's the vegetarian meal. And of course, the dessert was the cheese, sour, cherry cake, ice cream, sorbet. That day, the ice cream was, I think it was a matzka, which is like a mascarpone flavor. And then they had a tropical fruit, which I couldn't pronounce. And of course, the cheese plate and the fruit plate. And the cheese of the day was French cow's milk cheese. And they have a different cheese every night. So that's the amuse-bouche. It was like a little chicken thing. And that was the crusted potato thingy. That's the tomato basil soup. And that's the salmon, I can't remember what it's called, carpaccio. That's the carpaccio. And there's the roast, that's the beef. I had the ribeye that night. It was delicious. And then there's the three berry mascarpone dessert, which was really good. Breakfast the next morning, Eggs Benedict. I love the Eggs Benedict. Multivitamin juice, coffee, and orange juice. Yes, I had all three. And then lunch that day, we had the salami platter with pickles. Or stuffed eggs with salmon caviar. The soup of the day was celery, cream of celery. And then they had the farfalle pasta with, it had like scallops and shrimp and a bunch of other things. Or the German sauerbraten, which was just German sausage with a potato dumpling. I had that because I was in Germany. You eat brats in Germany. Or the tuna melt on brioche with the tempura pickles. Deep fried pickles. So good. And you can mix and match. You can tell them, I want a side of the pickles. So there's the seafood pasta. There's the salami and the eggs. There's the tuna melt. There's the celery soup. There is the cream puff. There's the ice cream. And then dinner that night was baba ganoush with spinach hummus. Or goat cheese and pine nut brulee, avocado and fennel apple salad with smoked salmon and clam chowder. I had the clam chowder, I know that already. And then the main course was pepper crusted chicken breast or macadamia nut crusted black cod. Or you could have the glass noodles with shiitake mushrooms. They always have a vegetarian option and low sodium options. And then the cheese of the night was Munster and a Swiss cow's cheese. And then the same thing, okay? So there's a little amuse-bouche. You got a little shrimp cocktail. There's the bread basket. There's the clam chowder. There's the carrot, cucumber, whatnots. There's the baba ganoush stuff. So, pictures of the food. I'm sorry they're not brighter. It's dark in the dining room. And then that's one of the desserts. It was like a chocolate mousse. And I always loved that they had decorative chocolate every single day. The following morning, I had a spinach omelet with some oatmeal with fostered bananas. And then there's the fresh mozzarella they made on the ship that day. There's the schnitzel and my salad. And I believe that was the carrot ginger soup. And David had like a breakfast burrito wrap or something. It was a chicken Caesar wrap. It was cauliflower soup. So tomato, mozzarella, and pesto. It was basically a deep fried tomato. And then the crisp apple beignets. Right there, you guys. So good. So, as you can see, I'm just gonna go through the rest of the pictures so you can see everything. They do not skimp on portion sizes. The food is always amazing. There's David having a coffee. That is a schneeball. This is in Rotenburg de Tauber, the city with the red wall. City. And those are basically just a bunch of pie crusts made into a snowball and covered with hazelnut or chocolate or powdered sugar or cinnamon sugar. As you can see, I got the hazelnut with sprinkles. And then we went to Faust and had a freshly brewed beer. Okay. And then this is where we had the tour guide that told us about the Franconians and the Bavarians. And the Franconian menu was a Franconian potato soup with a bratwurst made with wine, sauerkraut, and mashed potatoes with apple strudel and vanilla sauce, French white bread with butter, and then you got one coffee or a tea. And if you wanted, you could have either the Müller medium dry beer, or you could have the Jeunetier, which is basically a dry wine. So yeah, yum. But she was very critical of the Bavarians over the Franconians. And there's the potato soup. And there's the brats. And there's the strudel. And then that night, we got a little California roll. And what was so cute is they had this little, like, plastic thing with soy sauce in it. So you could, if you wanted to, you could put soy sauce on your amuse-bouche. And there's your wasabi and there's your ginger. And there's the little soy sauce thing. And this is a puff pastry with mushrooms. I can't remember what it was called. And that's the spring roll. I had 4 or 5 of these for my meal because nothing else looked good. And there's the jasmine rice. Because I ordered this fish and then I was like, And they didn't complain. They just, they were going to take it away. And Dave was like, no, it's okay. I'll eat it. But I was just like, no. And then the next day, I believe this was the pumpkin soup. Yeah, the pumpkin soup. That was really good. I've never had a bad soup on a Viking cruise ship. And I love their ranch dressing because it's made with pesto and it's so tasty. That's the fish and chips with the smashy peas. Aren't they beautiful? And the ice cream. All right, this is obviously, I think we're in Bamberg. Yeah, this is in Bamberg. And in Bamberg, there is a place in Bamberg where you can get smoked beer, okay? And blackberry currant. That's the blackberry currant. That's the smoked beer. And the smoked beer tastes like bean with bacon soup. And then this is, that's the bamboo shoot that it's cooked on, but that's a chicken thing. And this is where everyone made fun of me on the cruise ship because I would always order milk. instead of wine or alcohol, because wine and alcohol reacts badly and poorly. So I would always get a glass of milk. So Marlon, our server, would just bring me my milk in a stein, in a beer glass. And I was known as Moo Juice on that. There's Marlon. And he was our server on our Rhine getaway cruise. And when we were on the Rhine getaway, Marlon introduced David and I to his new wife because he got married. That's Rona. And Rona and Deb live in Washington. And we kind of adopted them as our aunts. So here's another one. We'll keep going through. That's the mushroom soup. Beef carpaccio, lamb chops, cheese plate. I got the cheese plate every night. Ooh, that was the passion fruit mousse right here. Passion fruit mousse. So good. And that was another strudel or something. And then the next day, and again, sorry, some of the pictures are bad because some of these pictures I took with my old camera. This was before I had a cell phone that had a camera that took decent pictures. Now I take almost everything with my cell phone. There's the curly fries and in the warm Cuban sandwich and soup. Okay. And there's another thing that I loved. This is another thing that I always, every time, and I'm looking forward to this again. What do they call this? It's the mushroom vol-au-vent. It was so good. And then the mushroom vol-au-vent is basically a puff pastry with mushrooms and peas. Oh my gosh. That was one of my favorite meals too. I like pastries, you guys. So the puff pastries are always a favorite. And that's the deconstructed mushroom lasagna right here. It's deconstructed. I don't know why they do it that way, but it was good. That was the bacon-wrapped filet medallions. And then this was another specialty tour we went on because the water levels were low and we were going through the Rhine Valley. They put us on a specialty ship that could get through the Rhine Valley so we could still see the Rhine Valley and see all the castles. So as we were doing our ship swap, they had us on another ship, and they served us this meal on this other ship. And it wasn't bad, but then we get into the next ship, because this is our next ship. And again, I'm so grateful that everything is the same from ship to ship. The staff went with us. That's the crepe with all the good stuff in it. So you still had the same staff who knew your needs, who knew your wants, who knew what you would order, anticipate your needs, and he brought me my milk every night. All right, so that's Ned. He was the guy who cooked the omelets every morning, and that's Catalin, and he was one of the bartenders. And there is Stu. Oh, he was so cute. There's the grilled cheese sandwich. There's the pasta. And there's the smoked duck breast. And there's Stu again. And right here, that's Scott. He is such a sweet guy. And we're in Melk in Austria. As you can see from right above our heads, we're in Melk that day. And the Melk Abbey was really cool too. I'll go over the itinerary on another day. So here is our port talk. Oh, and the lady in the wheelchair. Our first day on the ship, she tore her Achilles and couldn't walk. But she didn't want to leave the ship and go home. So Viking got a wheelchair and everybody took turns pushing her around on the tour so she wouldn't miss anything. It was really cool. All right, and then we went to Faust and had beer. This is German night, so we have all the German sausage and all the pretzels with all the mustards. That was the menu on German night. Yum. Yum. And yum. And oh my gosh. Alright, this is one of those little bakeries outside of the Melk Abbey. As you can see, it's clearly Christmas time. Okay. And, Oh, is this the one in Vienna? No, this is the Vienna place. This is one of the oldest coffee houses in Vienna. And I believe I got one of these cupcakes, if I remember right. Yes, and here's the other nice thing about the Vienna coffee houses. Your coffee comes with alcohol. So, I did get the lemon one. So David got an espresso, and in his espresso, he had a shot of, I can't remember what alcohol, but they brought it to him. And there's the freshly made mozzarella with the fresh pesto and the basil tomato salad. It's really just a sampling. If you wanted to sample everything, you could, because they're small enough that you could just take one little plate of everything. And there's some of the pesto pasta with the root vegetables. And then if you want the pulled pork with the French fries, you could. More stuff. Yummy. There's the quiche, the frittata, so good. And there's the garbanzo. I think it's something that starts with a P, if I can remember right. I'm not going back. There's the bread pudding with the ice cream. There's the cherry compote. Look what they did with the chocolate on the plate, you guys, because we were in Vienna, which is known for music. They put musical notes on every single plate. Somebody took their time to do that, which is such a cute and special little touch. And then for our farewell dinner, because this was in Budapest, this was our farewell dinner. They told us what our wine selections were. So you can have the salmon tartare or the tandoori chicken with parmesan foam, white asparagus voulet, or pumpkin mousse ravioli. I had everything on this farewell menu because I couldn't make up my mind. So I ate everything, okay? Then you had the deconstructed beef Wellington, pan-fried prawns with saffron beurre blanc with a potato souffle and a sausage fennel. And then you had the chocolate tart with the mango chutney stuff. It was so good. And you got to keep the menu and take it home. So there is the farewell dinner. That beef Wellington was so good. The raviolis were so good. And then they brought you a plate of bonbons that they made on the ship with edible glitter. And I asked for a second plate and they brought it to me. I was like, I want more of those. So I got two plates of the bonbons, you guys. It was so good. And then after our farewell dinner, they took us on a loop around Budapest at night so we could see Parliament and all the beautiful buildings at night with their lights on. And then the next day we went up to the Pest side and we explored a labyrinth and had a cute little Hungarian meal with baba ganoush and a whole bunch of other stuff. So, and those are the prices in kroners. So, goulash soup, chicken, paprika, and then the daily dessert, which was a donut, which I thought was so cute. The daily dessert was just a little glazed donut, and that's the spätzle with the baba ganoush. And it was all the young kids. And then this was our last night. There's Sam and Jennifer. They were on their honeymoon, but everyone thought David and I were on our honeymoon. And I'm like, no, we've been married for years. But they were so cute. And then that's Asia. And that's Kyle. That's Lynn. And that's Scott. And Scott's a photographer for the National Geographic, and he was just tired. Cheese plate, yes. I did it every single night, and I have no regrets. No regrets. And then, as we were flying out of Paris, I got myself some macaroons. So, that is the food on Viking. You will never be disappointed with the food you get on Viking River cruises. As some of you guys know, we recently did the Viking Mississippi River cruise, and I was not disappointed at all with the food on the Viking Mississippi. It was all amazing. And I like that they do food based on what region of the world you're in. So if you're in a region where they do home style cooking, you get home style cooking. But they always try to stick with locally sourced meals while you're on the ship. So I'm looking forward to one of these days doing a Pacific cruise with Dave where we go to like Bali and Thailand and Vietnam and maybe up to Japan. That's a bucket list item that we're saving to do someday. But yeah, I'm looking forward to finding out what the regional food is on those cruise ships. So tomorrow we'll talk about the itinerary and what you can expect, and I will show some pictures of some beautiful scenes. But Viking River Cruises is so great just because the food. I mean, that's the hands down number one reason I like Viking. The service is phenomenal, but the food is even better. So, all right, you guys, thanks for being here and enjoy this. I know it's a little different from paparazzi stuff, but that's okay. We're just gonna do something fun and not stressful for the next couple of weeks. So I hope you enjoyed. Leave your comments down below. Thanks. Bye.